Hello everyone, my name is Javier Lara. I'm here today to talk about new developments for CFD hybrid modeling for numerical wave tanks. This is the list of my co-authors of this work. He is Benedetto Di Paolo, PhD student at University of Cantabria, Gabriel Barajas, senior CFD modeler at IH Cantabria, Maria Maza, Juan de la Cierva researcher at IH Cantabria, Julio García Maribona, PhD student also in CFD at IH Cantabria, and Inigo Losada, full professor at IH Cantabria and scientific director of the institute. This is the outline of my presentation. Then I will start with some motivation. Then I will introduce you the methodology we use for this work. I will also use some validation and application of the work. And finally, I will finish with some conclusions. So the scope of the work, the motivation is we have an increasing number of works that has been using numerical wave tanks. This technique has been very popular in the last 5-10 years, and this the point or the one of the problems they have is it's very time consuming, especially we're dealing with three-dimensional problems, with especially this kind of method are very, very useful because are able to provide a lot of information about the flow patterns when the wave interact with coastal structures. So the goal of this work is try to save some computational costs and develop new methodologies to try to mimicking laboratory facilities. So we're trying to design a numerical wave tank to study three-dimensional flow patterns. So what we have think is to develop some couple numerical wave tank, which is able to combine two-dimensional flow solvers when the flow is basically two-dimensional and three-dimensional flow solvers when the flow is fully three-dimensional and what is the bottom, what is especially the bottleneck of these simulations, where it's very where the part of the domain is more time-consuming and we have to make more effort to solve that part of the fluid. So this is a clear example about what we pretend. So this is a wave propagating over a horizontal bed. We have the slope and the waves propagate toward the slope and then shoal on the slope until producing breaking, and then after breaking they develop a fully three-dimensional flow field. So it's not really very useful to solve this part of the domain where the flow is basically two-dimensional without two-dimensional flow solvers. So we thought that perhaps using a two-dimensional flow solver for this part and three-dimensional flow solver for the fully three-dimensional flow patterns were more useful and we could save some computational time. So that's the reason we have developed these 2 and 3D coupled numerical wave tanks. Of course, between the two, we need a coupling interface, and this coupling interface needs to be very strictly designed or very strategically designed in the part where the flow remains two-dimensional, in order to avoid these kind of problems, especially because the flow needs to be two-dimensional to ensure the good continuity between the two solvers. So the methodology is very simple. It's based on develop a multi-region approach. So we have multi-solvers in multi-region approach. One of the progress of this methodology is that we don't have any overlapping scheme, means that we have no parts of the domain they are used to run the models, but they are not really used to transfer information to the other solvers. So they are, all the information is transferred through the boundaries of the meshes. And we have developed two ways of coupling. This one way, what we call one way or weak coupling, and two way or strong coupling. This coupling has been developed, both has been developed in open form platform and has been introduced in the classical methodology we have been using the last 10 years with our IHFOAM model, in which this is still working with interform solver. So the one-way coupling is basically a way to transfer information from a two-dimensional domain into a three-dimensional domain, but there is no transference information from the three-dimensional domain to the two-dimensional domain back. So what we have here is a two-dimensional domain that can be run in advance, and we have to define an area, in this case, this red line, which is the point or the line we would like to use to transfer that information to the three-dimensional domain to be afterwards executed. So this part is fitted by the information of the three-dimensional domain at this line. This is different from, or similar from, to when we are using a classical boundary condition to for a three-dimensional domain, but the main difference is that this information is that can be extracted from the two-dimensional domain could contain the information of the wave transformation, for example, due to the bed, shoaling, or due to the nonlinear interaction with the bed or other submerged structure, which still preserve the two-dimensionality of the waves. The two-way coupling, as we call it, strong coupling. There is a full 3D transference of information between the two-dimensional and three-dimensional domain. Both meshes are included in the same matrix to be solved. Okay, so then we have a full transference of information between 2D and 3D in any time step, and we are able to do that through this boundary. So this red boundary is the boundary which is feeding the three-dimensional domain, and this green boundary is the one which is feeding information to the two-dimensional domain. This, the way the mathematical approach we follow is fully developed in Di Paolo et al. Papers, which is part of Benedetto Di Paolo PhD thesis. And these are two papers which are now under review with manual reviews. We expect to have them published in a short time in Coastal Engineering. You can go for the papers for get more details about the numericals which are behind the use of the meshes. So let me show you some validation. So the goal of the validation is first to ensure the continuity of velocity and pressure fields when we have the boundary, and then to check the difference between the wave kinematics when we use, as you can see in this figure, these couple domains, two-dimensional and three-dimensional, and we have these full 3D domains. So to see how is the difference between these three approaches. We will compare these two couplings with 3D simulations for different waves. We are talking about regular waves, random, solitary, and also we have developed some validation for first order and second order wave generation, including bounded long waves and free long waves interacting with the bed and also with the structures. So this is the first very simple validation. It's very simple numerical wave flume, flatbed. This is the one-way layout when different wave gauges. This is the wave gauge we use to feed afterwards the three-dimensional domain. And in the two-way layout, we use this the same location boundary as the previous before, which wave gauge number one. Okay, in the previous before a wave flume. And here what we have to do is to use this boundary to transfer the information between the two-dimensional region and the three-dimensional region. The 2D meshes contains only one cell in the spanwise direction. The three-dimensional ones contains 20 cells in the spanwise direction. These are some results. On top, you see, well, all the cases represent a solitary wave, which is traveling from left into right, reflecting at the wall, which is a fully reflection at the wall, which is located at this part of the boundary, and then the solitary wave is reflected back to the left. So here is the boundary, with this black line is located. You see that the continuity is almost perfect. Here we have a three-dimensional scenario or case. Here we have the two-way mesh, and here we have the one-way mesh. You see that the velocity field is very well reproduced by the two couple approaches. And when the wave is coming back to the boundary, we can see also that the continuity is almost very well, it's almost perfect, it's very well captured by the two-dimensional two-way couple scheme. And also when the one wave here we have a boundary, which is absorbing the wave, so there is no interference between the 2D, the 3D and 2D, and that's the reason we have this very sharp interface. Let me show you some examples about nonlinear wave transformation. This is a wave group located here close to the boundary, close to the, let's say, the boundary between the two-dimensional region and three-dimensional region, and a gauge, free surface gauge located here, which is within the three-dimensional region. As you can see, well, we have plotted the infragravity wave information twice. One in natural scale and the other one multiplied by a factor of 10, And we can see that the three schemes, the blue will represent the 3D, the black which represents the one-way scheme, and the red which represents the two-way, has very, very similar results, showing that the methodology is working very well, not only to transfer information about gravity waves, but also infragravity waves. The best thing, or the best idea is, or the best news is that we are able to speed up the computation in all the simulated cases in a factor close to 50%, which is pretty good because comparing with the three-dimensional case, which is pretty good because we can save a lot of computational time. Let me show you some application. This is an application of a methodology for a coupling scheme. This is a classical wave flume. And what we have done here is to study a case which is fully three-dimensional. We have an overtopping device here to extract energy with energy converter. And we have also another wave energy converter, which is an oscillatory wave column. All the wave patterns here are fully three-dimensional. So we have developed this technique, which the boundary is located far from the breakwater, where the flow is still being two-dimensional. And we are expecting to get here a computational load, safe load, which is approximately 75% of the whole of the case if we were using a fully three-dimensional mesh for the close to 70 meters long workflow. So these are part of the validation. The best thing is this is what you can see here, the coupling. You can see the difference between the 2D and the 3D. And here you can see that how the model is performing quite well with the validation for pressure inside the breakwater and also free surface located all along the basin. And the best thing is that this case is being able to be run in a 8 processor desktop computer in less than 2 days to generate close to 500 waves, which is a very competitive time for this case, because contains a lot of waves and also can be run in a very sophisticated supercomputing facility. This is the scheme. You can see where we have the 2D and the 3D, and then you can see also that the smoothness of the free surface comparing the two domains. Well, finally, let me come up with some conclusions. Conclusions that can be extracted from this work. We have developed this new design for numerical wave times with a coupling scheme for weak and strong grand trans coupling, validated with different wave characteristics for gravity and infragravity waves, first order and second order. The methodology has been used to mimic a physical flume tank. We can reduce the computational cost by a factor from 2 to 5. In the cases we have developed, and we have not all of them presented here, we have been using this in many, many cases. And this allows us to have a model that is very competitive with a very competitive computational cost for its application in coastal engineering practice. Well, just to finish with, this paper of this work is part of the extended work of Benedetto Di Paolo PhD thesis that contains information in these two papers that will be expect to be published. Thank you.